story's just begun. From the Great Plains of Nebraska to the California seas, from the summits of the Rockies to the mighty redwood trees, we're a thousand wheels of freight train here, the diesel engine's power. We're the Union Pacific, doing 90 miles an hour. And we've got the right of way. From the green fields of the prairies to the blue Pacific shore, we deliver your great cargo and come rolling home for more. On the backbone of our nation, you can see us make the climb. We're the Union Pacific, and we're gonna be on time. From the green fields of the prairies to the blue Pacific shore, we deliver your great cargo and come rolling home for more. On the backbone of our nation, you can see us make the climb. We're the Union Pacific, and we're gonna be on time.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Engines of Union Pacific, a series inspired by Engines of Septa by Thunderbolt 1000 Siren Productions and Engines of Amtrak by Amtrak Guy 365. Now, before we start, I just want to let everyone know that I'm not going to be doing every single engine that UP owned, as there would be way too many episodes, and not all the engines have interesting histories. But I will do as many as I can. Now, with that being said, it's time to talk about the famous gas turbines. Now, the reason we're doing this engine first is because this is an easy start for the series. We will not be covering the steam engines first, as their histories are a little complicated, but will be covered later on in the series, so don't worry to all you steam fans. So with that being said, let's talk about the Union Pacific gas turbines. Well, what can I say? Union Pacific has to be one of the most well-known railroad companies in the world and has been around for over 150 years. And boy, did they have lots of interesting locomotives over the years. In the mid to late 1940s, Union Pacific had decided that it was time to replace their large and mighty steam locomotives, such as the Big Boys, Challengers, and other large locomotives, with something that was more modern, more powerful, and more reliable. A new era was approaching for the railroads, and the UP had to find something that could replace the steam engines. The idea of putting diesel locomotives on their roster was avoided, as they thought that a diesel would never be able to replace a steam locomotive. They then looked into the idea that a turbine could possibly replace the big steam locomotives. In 1948, the UP received their first gas turbine, Number 50, a prototype demonstrator. The turbine was powered by a fuel called Bunker C heavy fuel oil, which was a fuel cheaper than diesel fuel. This fuel ran through a turbine engine similar to a jet engine on an aircraft, and the output shaft on the turbine was connected to a generator which generated electricity which ran traction motors, which drove the whole unit forward. The experiment with the gas turbine was successful, unlike the steam power turbines from 1938, which were deemed a failure due to the condenser unit not having enough power. After the success of the experimental gas turbine, UP then decided to order 10 of them, numbered 51 to 60, in 1952 by General Electric. These would be known as the first generation of gas turbines. Another thing about all these turbines is that they don't have a dual cab like experimental turbine 50. These first turbines weighed 552,000 pounds and had a tractive effort of 138,000 pounds. All the turbines originally didn't carry tenders with them, but later on they were all fitted with tenders. These tenders were made from scrap 412-2 steam locomotives, which were the 9000 class steam engines, and were converted to carry the fuel and had a capacity of 24,000 gallons. These turbines were a huge success for their first 2 years of service. Not too long after, Union Pacific decided to order another batch of gas turbines. This batch would be the second generation of gas turbines. They ordered 15, numbered 61 to 75, in 1954, also by General Electric. The gas turbines were not very fuel efficient. These turbines, however, couldn't replace the big steam engines. It wasn't until November 1955 when the Union Pacific received their third and final batch of gas turbines. These turbines were very different compared to the first two. They weighed 849,212 pounds. That's 385,196 kilograms. And had a tractive effort of 212,000 pounds. They had a power output of 8,500 horsepower, which makes it the strongest engine in the world. It is estimated that these turbines could pull 735 fully loaded freight cars at 12 miles per hour on leveled track. Unlike the first two generations of gas turbines, which were a single engine with a tender, this gas turbine was made up of three sections. The A unit, which contains the main controls and a diesel engine if the turbine isn't needed at the moment. The B unit, which contains the main 8,500 horsepower turbine engine in it. And a tender that was said to be used off the 484 Northerns, and held most of the Bunker C fuel, as well as an insulated system to heat the fuel instead of a steam generator like on the other two turbines. These turbines were originally going to be numbered as the 7000 class, but were instead numbered as the 1 class. Union Pacific ordered 30 of these turbines, numbered 1 to 30, also by General Electric. In fact, all these turbines were made by General Electric. These would be the last turbines ordered by the UP. The maximum speed for all three gens of the turbines was believed to be 65 miles per hour. That's 105 kilometers an hour. These turbines were given two nicknames, the Bird Burners and the Big Blows. The name Bird Burner was given to them because of their flaming fireballs that came out of the turbines themselves during a startup. Here's some footage of turbine number one doing exactly that.
Back in Ogden, Utah, turbine number one is getting ready to start up. But turbine startups don't always go smoothly.
The name Big Blow was given to them because the loud noise the turbines made sounded like a jet engine. Gen 1 and Gen 2 turbines were fitted with twin Leslie Typhon A-200 air horns, and the Gen 3 turbines were fitted with Leslie S-5T-RF air horns. Here are some samples of those horns.
Thank you.
turbines roamed the Union Pacific Railroad for many years. And I should also mention that there was an experimental turbine built in 1962. The UP was impressed with the gas turbines that they decided to do an experiment with a turbine and use a different source of power for a turbine. The result was a coal-powered turbine, which was the same thing as a gas turbine, but instead used coal. The coal turbine had a big boy tender on the back, and they put a grinding unit in it that grinds the coal to about the consistency of talcum powder that's piped into the center unit where the giant turbine lives, and the coal dust is fired into the turbine, generating electricity. This turbine was numbered 80, but later renumbered as 8080. But it was not too successful as the gas turbines, due to there being multiple problems, and was considered another turbine failure, just like the steam turbines. The gas turbines, however, were still the most successful turbines and kept running. The gas turbines were so successful that they in fact managed to last for at least a decade. However, though, it wasn't until the mid-1960s when UP decided to give diesel locomotives a chance. Fuel at this time was also starting to rise in cost. The UP then realized that they could get the same amount of power of a turbine by just lashing up a whole bunch of diesel locomotives. When this was realized, UP decided to start ordering lots of diesels, such as the GP30s and many other types of diesels. By 1963, Union Pacific began retiring the gas turbines. All Gen 1 turbines were retired by June 1964. All Gen 2 turbines were retired from August 1963 to June 1964. Gen 3 turbines started being retired in 1968, and the last run of a gas turbine was on December 26th, 1969. And by 1970, all gas turbines were retired. This closes the chapter of this amazing piece of machinery. Despite being an amazing piece of machinery, sadly, most of the turbines were scrapped. None of the Gen 1 turbines survived, and neither did the Gen 2 turbines. Prototype demonstrator turbine number 50 was also scrapped. And almost all of the Gen 3 turbines have been assumed scrapped. However, though, two of the Gen 3 turbines have survived, and both have been preserved. Turbine number 18 is currently preserved and on display at the Illinois Railway Museum in Illinois. And turbine number 26 is preserved and on display at the Utah State Railroad Museum in Ogden, Utah. these turbines hold the legacy of the gas turbines, in my opinion. And although the possibilities are slim, I hope that Union Pacific brings one of these turbines back on their roster and restore it. My high hopes are that they will take number 18 back home and restore it. I hope they bring back a turbine, even though the chances might be slim. Let's have our fingers crossed, hoping that they'll bring one back. I really hope they bring one back. Well, there you go. That was the Union Pacific gas turbine. Wow, that was a lot of information. The turbine was an amazing piece of machinery, that's for sure. Next episode, we will be talking about one of Union Pacific's first ever freight diesels, the GP30. I hope you guys will be excited for when that comes out, but for now, you must wait. Stay tuned for the GP30. Hope you enjoyed the video, and with that being said, this is Automatic, signing off! We'll be right back.